Should you file personal bankruptcy while the coronavirus crisis continues? I'm Jonathan Ginsberg. I'm an Atlanta area personal bankruptcy attorney. And now we've been in the era of coronavirus for about 6 months as I'm recording this. And it looks to me like we're going to be dealing with this problem for at least another 6 months, if not a year or year and a half. Up until now, I have not seen a lot of bankruptcy filings because I think that many creditors, be they lenders, car lenders, mortgage lenders, credit card companies, are holding back on pursuing any kind of remedy. Many of the courts have been closed for civil actions, so we're not seeing a lot of lawsuits. People are out of work, so they're basically judgment proof. So there have not been a lot of really significant motivations for people to go into a personal bankruptcy. And that's not a bad thing, because I think the bankruptcy should not be something that addresses short-term problems. It also should not be something you should turn to if there are other alternatives. If you have stimulus money that can get you through, if you can work things out with your creditors, you should do that. But I think at some point, we're going to hit the time where creditors are not going to hold off anymore. I'm starting to see more evictions, and this is more in the commercial side. And of course, if you're a small business owner and you've got a personal guarantee, an eviction or a lawsuit can affect you personally. We're going to start to see vehicle for repossessions because, again, vehicle lenders are looking at a depreciating asset if you're not able to pay your car payment, and that goes on for 4, 5, 6 months. At some point, the lender is going to say, we're just going to take the vehicle back. Same with foreclosures. I think that at some point, lenders are going to say, you know, we'd rather have the property back. We're going to force the issue a little bit. So what should you do? Well, obviously, there are two types of bankruptcies individuals can file, Chapter 7 and Chapter 13. And Chapter 13 is a payment plan which will stop foreclosures, stop repossessions, and give you up to 5 years to pay things back. The issue with the 13 is you've got to have cash flow. And if you're not sure what's going to be in the next 3, 6 months, I would really be hesitant to file a Chapter 13. If you're in the type of business that's been affected by the coronavirus, you're a personal trainer, you're in personal services, you're in retail, you're in food service, hotels, transportation, things like that, I would be really hesitant to file a Chapter 13 because we just don't know what's going to be in 6 months from now. Chapter 7 is an option, and now that 6 months has gone by, the means test won't be an issue as much if you had very little income, since the means test looks back in the last 6 months. That will not be a problem, whereas 3 or 4 months ago, the means test would have considered income when you were actually working. So means test could maybe qualify you for Chapter 7. That may be something to look at. And again, it can be a really difficult choice to make because when you go into a Chapter 7, typically you're surrendering things you can't afford. So it may mean you've got to surrender that house or that car, but it can give you a little bit of peace of mind. And one of the things that I'm reading about a lot is that folks, because of job interruption, there's a certain level of depression going on. It can be very, very difficult. Obviously, family violence. There's a lot of negative stuff going on with the mental health side of the coronavirus crisis. So I would tell you that, you know, if income is not steady right now and you don't see any real change coming in the future and the type of work you do is not something that's going to bounce back very quickly, then it might be worth looking into Chapter 7 just to sort of wipe it all out, be done with the debts, and start over again. Because it's just not worth going into a 13 to try to save a house and a car when you won't have the money to do so. And right now, the types of jobs, some industries, unemployment's 25-30%. I would not go into a Chapter 13 for something like that. But on the other hand, sometimes waiting and doing nothing can make sense as well. So what I would tell you is if you are feeling the pressure, you're starting to sense that your creditors are calling, obviously, some of it may be a bluff, some of it may be something really happening, but you know, if you need some advice about what to do, how to approach it, pick up the phone and call us. I mean, Susan Bloom and I talk to folks all the time, and a lot of times we say, don't do anything. Let's just wait and see what happens. Because again, I think many creditors are just doing wait and see right now. That may go on for another 3 or 4 months. But if you're not sure, call me, call Susan, 770-393-4985. We'll kind of walk you through the process. What you don't want to do is to make any rash decisions. I talked to somebody this week who'd filed a pro se Chapter 7 to stop a foreclosure. Big mistake, because it basically tied up all of her her bank accounts, and she's going to lose, you know, I think $25,000, when all she would have lost before would have been her house. So don't make any rash moves. This poor lady went to a petition preparer and got really, really bad advice. Don't do that. You're much better off calling a lawyer like us, like me or Susan, and we'll be happy to walk you through the process. But we're still not at the point — I'm recording this in July of 2020. We're still not at the point where I think things have hit crisis mode. So it may be we still need to take a wait and see attitude. But if you're thinking about planning for the future, the best advice I would tell you is be realistic. Don't assume things are going to get better very quickly. I don't think they will. I think that if you need to focus on your peace of mind, your mental health, and getting through these really tough times, if that means starting over again, that's what it means. So hope you found this useful. Please give it a thumbs up on YouTube or on Facebook if you found it useful. Visit us online. Our website is atlanta-bankruptcy-attorney.com. And again, we can be reached at 770-393-4985. My name is Jonathan Ginsberg. I look forward to hearing from you soon. Thanks a lot. Hi, this is Jonathan, and I hope you found this video helpful. I'd like to invite you to download my free Debt Destroyer Survival Kit right now. I've packed my survival kit with answers to the questions I've heard from clients for over 25 years here in the Atlanta area. Inside the survival kit, you'll find clear, easy to understand answers to critical topics about how to solve debt problems once and for all, including how do I protect my stuff, my house, car, and personal property if I file for bankruptcy? Are there any legitimate alternatives to bankruptcy? Will I ever get credit again, and if so, when? What mistakes must I avoid to get the most benefit out of bankruptcy? You can claim your copy right now by visiting my atlanta-bankruptcy.com website. And you are always welcome to use the email form on my website to ask me anything about debt and personal bankruptcy in Atlanta. www.atlanta-bankruptcy.com. And as always, I wish you the best.